While the setup menu in Salesforce should really be the exclusive access of admins, developers, or consultants, there are plenty of places that end users can go to update their own settings without any specialized help at all. Every user has their very own personal settings, which can be found in the top right-hand corner of their screen by clicking on the profile icon and then selecting settings. In here, we can find a huge array of settings that the user has complete control over, from notifications to personal information to changing their password. Today, we'll run through some of the most useful personal settings for your users to know. The first one is pretty clear, it's just changing your password. You don't need to get your admin in for this. Users can change their own password right from their own personal settings. It's super easy. Just search for change my password in the quick find search box and then follow the instructions there. The second one is changing language, time zone, or currency. These days, everyone is moving around a lot, so updating these for each user individually can be a real pain for one admin to handle. Fortunately, each user can set their own language, time zone, and currency preferences by just searching for language and time zone in their personal settings. They can even change their locale, which is a setting that controls things like date formats or address formats. Instead of using a US date format, you might want to use an Australian or English or New Zealand one. The third one is finding your username. This sounds simple, but often users will forget their username. It happens. Once they are in Salesforce, showing them where they can find their username so they can store it in a secure password manager is actually a really, really great thing to do. Users can find their own username by going to their personal settings and then just checking out personal information. They'll find it right there. The fourth one is notifications. Notifications can be a blessing or a curse. You either love them and you revolve your life around them, or you hate them. This isn't something that a Salesforce admin needs to control for every user. Users can set their preferences themselves. We all like different notification settings. All they need to do is search for activity reminders in the quick search in their personal settings, and they can select from the list of notification options there. If they're after chatter notifications, which is where most of your email notifications are going to come from, then just search email notifications and you'll be able to turn those off or on as you like. All done. The fifth one is email settings. Users can set their own email signature in their personal settings by searching for My Email Settings. You can decide which name you'd like to use for outgoing mail, which email you'd like the return address to be, and you can set your own email signature. Just so you know, it's probably better to copy and paste your email signature from another source, since the font selection and formatting here is pretty basic. The sixth and final one is that users can add themselves to default opportunity and account teams. If a user is the owner of an opportunity or sits above the owner of an opportunity in the role hierarchy, they can create their own opportunity teams, add other users, and set the access level for their team members. As we talked about before, they can do this straight from the opportunity by using the opportunity team related list, and then directly share that opportunity instantly with their team. If they wanted to create a default opportunity team, the one that's all set up and ready to go, they can do this themselves by going to their personal settings, clicking on Advanced User Details, and then Default Opportunity Team. Once they're there, they can add their default team, choose their users, select their roles, their access, and they're ready to go. You can even add them to all your existing opportunities if you like, but maybe it's just best to add them to new opportunities you create from now on. The exact same thing applies for account teams, but on the account side instead of the opportunity. So when you're searching for any settings, instead of searching for default opportunity teams, search for default account teams instead. That's six of the most useful features in each user's personal settings. There's plenty more there to play around with, but the main thing is that your Salesforce users know that it exists. It saves you time, it saves your users time, and it just makes for a happy company in Salesforce.